Now, Rapelang has been featured on the cover of Forbes Africa magazine before the age of 30. Now, if you can find the cover of Forbes Africa, surely you can try and calculate how old she is now. Not just that, she was also selected as a young global leader by the World Economic Forum. She's an internationally lauded technology entrepreneur. Let's enjoy the video from Rapelang.
Does every project in your company start with a design sprint? Are you using metered funding? Are you able to build the creative muscle in your organization that will deliver innovation? How do you make decisions? Are you using market data, or does the hippo, the highest paid person's opinion, decide? Do you have a North Star metric that you're tracking, and does that grow 20% every month? Have you implemented an innovation accounting dashboard? Can you say yes to all of those questions that I've asked? High growth startups can, and that's what gives them the competitive edge. I have always been intrigued at how companies with so many resources can still struggle to get things done. That was until I was able to observe that decision-making and resource allocation process. From what I've observed, right, there's an idea that comes up, and then there's tons of documentation that's produced, slides and PowerPoints and spreadsheets of all sorts. And there's this business case that forms the basis of it, and it's always viable because, I mean, any assumption can be made to make a business case viable. Then some experts are called in and they have to validate and check some of the numbers. And it's really all just a cover your rear exercise in case things go wrong. Then, you know, a decision to spend tens of millions of rands is made based on how well someone presents and the chemistry in the room. And this gets us to the place where resources are squandered. The thing with digital strategies and innovation is that the thinking actually happens in the doing, and there's too little doing in this particular approach. It turns out that having far less resources actually forces a better decision-making process, much like in my own startup experience. You see, we cobble together what we can and start implementing something that we can take to the customer and start engaging. We get feedback, we learn, we scrap an idea, or we fix it based on that feedback, and we cobble some more resources together and try again, improve the solution, and keep going until we actually hit product market fit. The good thing is that by employing contemporary business management techniques, even large, well-established companies can fast forward that innovation journey. For starters, there's creativity-driven design sprints that you can use to create high-fidelity prototypes that you can put in front of a customer to validate or even invalidate a business idea. There's lean innovation approaches that you can apply to iteratively improve on a product and allocate funding in a metered way. There's digital collaboration options that allow you to connect with startups and innovative companies to reduce your time to market in implementation. And there's also growth hacking that you can use to adopt low-cost promotion techniques that drive incredible growth. There are so many better ways to work. One snag, though: if gobbledygook goes in at the beginning, gobbledygook comes out at the end. Which begs the question, how do you improve the quality of the ideas that come out of your team? How can you improve the frequency of those ideas? Can creativity, the seed of innovation, actually be taught? At this point, when I ask if creativity can be taught, most people get a funny feeling, because this is our perception of creativity. We intend to hype up our team to do an awesome brainstorming session. And we know things will get a bit tricky in the middle, and you're going to have to push your team to be more creative, to think laterally, to think out of the box, right? And you just hope to God, by the end of it, you will have something decent to show for your efforts. The truth is, that's not how creativity actually works. Creativity has never been about thinking out of the box. Let's say you need to organize someone's birthday and you want to make it really special, and I tell you, think out of the box. What happens? Does a light bulb go off in your mind? I don't think so. You probably go completely blank, like most people do. Creativity just doesn't work like that. You see, from the time we are born, as we begin to consume information and try to make sense of the world around us, we start organizing everything into boxes. That's just how the human mind works. We create the food box, the mummy box, the fun and games box. And as we get older, the boxes get more complex, and the number of boxes we create in our minds just explodes. Quite simply, creativity is about becoming aware of the boxes in your mind, becoming aware of how you have organized information so that you can think into different boxes, so that you can connect boxes that were not connected before. When we use digital technologies, we're ultimately trying to find a new method or technique to break a previous constraint and solve a problem better. But before you can decide what technology you want to use, you have to first break the constraints in your mind, which is all about rearranging the boxes in your brain. To figure out how to rearrange those boxes requires you to reactivate your creative DNA that all of us had when we were born, but is being beaten out of us through school and our social norms. And I'm sure most of you are shaking your head, but I assure you, we all have creative DNA inside of us. In a study a few years ago, 98% of five-year-olds scored at genius levels in terms of creativity. And unfortunately, by the time they reached adulthood, only 2% of them were still scoring at genius levels. The good news, though, is that creativity can be taught. Even adults can regain extremely high levels of creativity. In the words of Steve Jobs, innovation has nothing to do with how many R&D dollars you have. It's about the people you have, how they are led, and how much you get it. You see, running those creativity-driven workshops or lean innovation sprints or those growth hacking interventions helps you unlock the potential of your people and position your company for repeatable and sustainable innovation. At the end of the day, the only thing that has ever truly changed culture is when we change how we work and how we make decisions. You can fast forward innovation.